Chris died on May 17 at the age of 52. The medical examiner's office said in a statement, the cause of death has been determined as hanging by suicide. A full autopsy report has not yet been completed, after conducting an initial autopsy. A police spokesman told two Detroit newspapers that the singer was found hanged. The Wayne County office, there is no additional information at this time. Dad of three, Cornell, has been due to play at U.S. Festival Rock the Range in Columbus on May 18. His last tweet saw him post a picture outside the Fox Theater in Detroit, Michigan, where he performed with Soundgarden, with the Pretty Reckless supporting. Meanwhile, new details have emerged about the singer's last day. Bodyguard Martin Kirsten saw the 52-year-old rock star moments before his hotel suicide police papers reveal. Mr. Kirsten, who previously dated Heidi Klum, helped the singer fix his computer and gave him two Ativan sleeping pills. But the security man had to kick in two hotel doors after receiving a panicked call from Cornell's wife, Vicky Karayiannis, who reported the singer slurring his words in a final phone call. Mr. Kirsten says he found the star lying on the bathroom floor, with blood running from his mouth, according to the police report. Papers obtained by the Detroit News, claims that after finishing his last show at 11:30 p.m. on Wednesday night, Cornell was escorted to his room at Detroit's MGM Grand Hotel by Mr. Kirsten. Ms. Karayiannis said, when we spoke after the show, I noticed he was slurring his words, he was different. When he told me he may have taken an extra Ativan or two, I contacted security and asked that they check on him. A lawyer for the family has since confirmed Cornell took this for his anxiety, police reports reveal. The family of the musician, who struggled with addiction before seeking treatment in 2002, dispute the cause of death, instead suspecting that he suffered adverse effects from either Ativan or other substances. Kirk Passage, a lawyer for the family, said, without the results of toxicology tests, we do not know what was going on with Chris, or if any substances contributed to his demise. Chris, a recovering addict, had a prescription for Ativan and may have taken more Ativan than recommended dosages. The family believes that if Chris took his life, he did not know what he was doing, and that drugs or other substances may have affected his actions. Ativan has been said to give users suicidal thoughts if taken in a high dosage. Morbid fans of the tragic rock star have been calling the MGM in the hope of staying in the same room where he died. Death-obsessed tourist phoned the venue asking to rent room 1136 where the Soundgarden singer killed himself. The Detroit Free Press reported that the room in question is unavailable and there's no date for when or if it will be used for guests again. A reporter from the publication managed to book for $600, £463, a night room but was told 1,136 was not available and offered another room when they turned up.